I'll steal a little bit from Tom, but I think that we have a lot going on. We've made some initiatives, kind of shifting our focus a little bit from data center consolidation and a centralized model where we're putting things more in a data center, but taking that moment to pause and say, are these workloads that we should be doing in a commercial cloud environment? Navy came out in 2017 with a commercial first initiative, and we're really looking at the funding aspect before we do IT spend to say, are these workloads that should go into commercial cloud? What makes sense for it? Along with that, we're looking at how to empower the resource sponsors and the functional area managers to look at their portfolio of applications. We're trying to bring in the warfare commanders and help them manage their portfolios, but really look at this from a portfolio aspect and stop looking at it as a individual application movement, kind of a data center framework, but rather let's look at it from a portfolio aspect and what makes sense to get into the cloud and how can we do this a little bit more smartly. Part of what we're trying to do this year is we're calling it our bridge year. We're really trying to enable as many vehicles as we can or avenues we can for the application owners and functional area managers to get their workloads to the cloud. So we have our Navy Enterprise cloud vehicle that's coming online here in June. What we're doing is using that as a kind of an intermediary step before we get to the JEDI contract offering. Mm-hmm. But what we really realized is the timing that we needed, we had to have an interim contract in place to kind of move this along. And so what we're really targeting is a managed service provider, looking at how we can provide some shared services for those applications and still work with those industry partners in bringing in more and more commercial services.
Mm-hmm. Okay.